If you can't yet do a chin-up, trying to improve your chin-up by struggling to do a single rep over and over will lead you nowhere because this kind of training does not allow for a gradual progression. When trying to improve any strength exercise, you must start with a relatively easy challenge and then gradually increase the difficulty over time. This gradual approach allows the body to adapt effectively to the exercise, develop proper technique, and recover well between training sessions. Rushing strength training will lead to a quick halt in progress and/or injury. But the problem is, how can you use a gradual progression for an exercise when you can't even perform a single rep of it? The chin-up poses a significant challenge in this regard because to do just one repetition, you have to move 100% of your body weight, which is often impossible to those new to strength training. The chin-up is different than most every other strength exercise because in most exercises, you are able to use weights that range from light to heavy in small increments. But with a chin-up, you are put in a position to move heavy weight from the get-go. Expecting a beginner to be able to do a single chin-up on day one of training is like expecting them to bench press their body weight when they first walk into a gym, which almost all people are unable to do. In response to the particular challenge of improving chin-ups, this video presents an effective method of chin-up training for individuals who cannot yet perform a single rep or for individuals who struggle to do just a few reps. This method is effective because it uses a gradual progression that allows individuals to perform the sets and reps necessary to build strength. Before I start talking about this progressive method, just a couple things to note. Linked in the description is a free chin-up program that will help you to do your first rep using the method presented in this video. And at the end of this video, there will be a link to another video that addresses common technique mistakes made when doing the chin-up and how to avoid them. There are two primary chin-up modifications in this progressive chin-up method: the band-assisted chin-up and the jumping chin-up with an isometric hold at the top and a slow, controlled descent. First, the band-assisted chin-up. You'll need flat, rectangular loop bands that look like this. Ideally, you'll have at least two bands that vary in tension, but the more the better. Start with the band that has the heaviest tension, the one that is hardest to stretch. Choke the band around the chin-up bar, taking out all the slack. Then, grabbing the hanging portion of the band, pull it down under one of your shins. It doesn't matter what shin, and a comfortable and balanced band position will vary between individuals. Set yourself directly under the bar, and then perform the chin-up. The band effectively reduces your body weight because it pulls your body up towards the bar. The heaviest tension bands will provide the most assistance, and progressively lighter bands will provide less assistance. So by doing the band-assisted chin-up with progressively lighter bands, you are essentially adding weight to the chin-up over time, not unlike the way you'd add increasingly heavier plates to a barbell. This gives you a progressive method so that you can gradually build the strength to be able to do a regular chin-up without any band assistance. Now onto the second modification, the jumping chin-up with a hold at the top and a slow, controlled descent. When doing the chin-up, the muscle groups that perform the upward part of the movement are the same muscle groups that are used when you control your body in the downward part of the movement. Therefore, by holding yourself at the top of the chin-up and then slowly lowering yourself, you will strengthen your ability to eventually pull your body upwards. The jumping chin-up with a hold at the top and a slow controlled descent is so valuable because you can stress the chin-up muscles in just the top of the lift and the lowering portion, even if you can't pull yourself up to the bar. There's also the opportunity to incorporate a gradual progression into this chin-up modification. You can increase the length of time that you hold yourself at the top and increase the time that you lower yourself. For example, you may perform reps of the jumping chin-up, holding yourself at the top for 1 second, and then lowering yourself for 1 second. Then the next week, hold yourself up for 2 seconds, and lower yourself for 2 seconds. If you are a shorter individual, or use a very high chin-up bar, you may need a box, bench, or platform to stand on in order to reach the bar when doing either of these chin-up modifications. If you don't have bands available to do the band-assisted chin-up, you can just use the jumping chin-up modification. However, using both chin-up modifications is best. The link in the description has a program that incorporates both chin-up modifications and a program that uses just the jumping chin-up if you don't have bands available. That does it for this progressive chin-up training method. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video and found it helpful, I suggest checking out my chin-up technique video entitled How to Prevent Swinging in the Chin-Up, which you can click on right in the center of the screen. This video will demonstrate common errors in the chin-up and how to fix them.